don't we keep it real with each other? How we feel for one another? Love at first sight to if looks could kill a motherfucker. They say when a man give you his word, you can trust him. But your actions told me you a lying son of a.
Yo, listen.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
We keep it real with each other, how we feel for one another. Love at first sight to if looks could kill a motherfucker. They say when a man give you his word, you can trust him. But your actions told me you a lying son of a bitch. You gotta breathe, I be talking to myself, cause I know I tell the truth, I can't hear nobody else. You were never worthy of the feelings that I felt. You only hollered to get another notch up on your belt. Fell in love with the facade of heaven, but you was hell. Walking with me while holding hands with the devil himself. I wonder why your dream you thought you needed to sell. When from the door, I gave you the chance to keep it real. All I ever wanted, cause that's all I've ever been. Never had insecurities or trust issues with men. First time for everything, but never again. Will I forgive, then sit back and pretend it ain't over with.
Gave you my heart, you broke it in two. I found the pieces, I found the glue. Put it back together and what did you do? You broke it again. Now it's just pieces, pieces. It's just pieces in my heart blowing in the wind.
Trust. How do you get it back? Some say it's possible, but what's the percentage of that? With the same face that spoke love, you put on an act. Look me dead in my eyes like them lies was the facts. You a fraud, nigga, claiming that you swore to God that you changed, but the show you put on deserves applause. Used to think it was me, but I never was the cause. You a steady lying to cover up the flaws you ain't think I saw. I overlooked them for a long time. Love don't judge, that's why you always hear the saying love is blind. Guess you felt you had to hide, I was down to ride. Gave you the signs, you should've opened your eyes. Woulda, coulda, don't matter now. You live and you learn. Some people just be the lesson you need for your next turn. I won't front, through the hurt you was a blessing. But no more chances, cause I see I messed up on a second. It's been
gave
real.
Gave you my heart, you broke it in two. I found the pieces, I found the glue. Put it back together and what did you do? You broke it again. Now it's just pieces. Pieces, it's just pieces in my heart blowing in the wind, yeah.
Yo, listen. 8SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people. 8Squad Rebel Radio.
It's on fire.
Home of the independent artist. The station that gets the block shaking.
8Squad Rebel Radio.
The most talked about internet radio station in the lion.
Mic check 1 2 1 2. Mic check 1 2 1 2. Yeah, man. Oh, come on. The flag has returned. Yo, Zay ain't shit, bro.
Yo, this nigga started already.
Bro, none. Yo. Yo, I don't really want no friends. How many of us have them? Yo, it's the No Man Program right here on 8 Squad Rebel Radio. We are back and we are on time. How about that? It's the first time.
It's a long time, right?
It's the first time. No, nigga, it's the first time. We have never been on time. Nigga, I've been keeping track.
We've been on time for some time.
Nah. Yo, man, it's the No Man Program where everything is on the table. Ladies, we take all the smoke, especially if you are cooking. If you are a business or you are an artist, you want to promote your business or promote your music on our station, you mean on our platform, definitely email us at nomanprogram@gmail.com. You can also follow us on IG at no_ma_program. You know what I'm saying? Also follow 8 Squad Rebel Radio as well, you know, at 8 Squad Rebel Radio. You know, keep up with the station. You know what I'm saying? Big up to Zay. Zay's in the building. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Big up to the engineer. You know what I'm saying? Mustafa's in the building. All right, man. Don't fuck my shit up this week. Last week, you was fucking with you, bro. Oh, my God. Flag on the play. That's two times. I'm wilding. Yo, bro, you gotta talk now. I got to take 30 seconds.
Yo, this guy. It's the red wine, bro. Stay out that red wine, bro. That shit got you sitting on the Sunday. You bugging. But while he on his timeout, we gonna start something new. We not gonna give y'all the sponsors all at one time because that's like draining. We gonna give it to you. Go freaky. Straight in, bro. No, I stopped. Caught myself.
Whoa, you caught yourself? Oh my God.
See, now he reaching because he got caught out there. That's a reach, bro. Nah, that's a reach. Reach it. But nah. Yo, let's get to the sponsors. So, our first half of the sponsors for the first half of the show, we like to shout out Royal Chicken and Biscuits, the best chicken in Newark. Downtown Newark, you can find them at 833 Broad Street, Newark, New Jersey. That's 833 Broad Street, New Jersey. That's Royal Chicken and Biscuits. Next, we got Custom Junkies for all your custom needs, custom apparel company right here, 17 Academy Street, Newark, New Jersey. Now, we have Rap Financial, the tax preparer and credit doctors. Shadira Birdsell, you can reach her at 866-890-7277. That is Rap Financial for all your tax preparer and credit needs. Oh, and lastly, for the first half of the show, for our sponsors, we have KD Notary Services. That's KD Notary Services. You can reach them at 973-440-3741.
Yes, sir. Yeah, man. So, yeah, we going to, you know, it's a few sponsors for now. You know what I'm saying? And as the show go on, you know, y'all get the rest.
Yes, sir.
And, yo, man, I'm here. Johnny Doe.
Me too.
How was your week, sir?
My week was all right. I can't complain about it. It was cool. Nothing really major happened, you know, so.
Oh, Tola. So last week, you was talking shit about me last week, saying how I'd just be like, oh, that's it.
No, you'd be like, yo, my week was horrible. Fuck Earth.
That don't even.
Yo, damn, bro.
I ain't gonna front. I do be talking like that. Yo, man.
Fuck the government.
You know, Act Turner is you know, he couldn't make it. You know what I'm saying? It's Ramadan. So, you know, the niggas that don't eat pork, you know what I mean? They doing something different.
He bugging.
Niggas that they doing something. They doing something different this month. You know what I'm saying? So, Act couldn't make it.
Act trying to use that to get a month off, man.
You say he trying to get a month. He trying to use that to get a month off.
Word. He but never be late for the rest of the year. He got a whole month. Yo, you better be on time every Sunday.
Oh my God!
And you can't miss no shows, bro. So that means you can't. I would have hit. Oh, I'm jammed at work. None of that shit, bro. Tell him fuck that. You got a show to do. It's your time.
This nigga shout out, bro. Yeah, but yeah, my week was cool. Big up to Tanya on the check-in. Big up to
Happy Sunday,
Act Turner.
You wild.
What up? You wild for not. You know what I mean? What's up?
So can you go to your regular job and be like, yo, but take off a month because it's Ramadan?
We want to. Inquiring minds would like to know.
No, that's no. You take an FMLA?
What? What's that?
Family leave.
Family leave. Yeah. Oh, yeah. FMLA.
Yeah. Family medical leave.
That, what's medical about that?
Hey, he can't eat hungry.
Yo, you got to get your man, Oh, man. Nah, my week was all right, bro.
Bro, I fasted for like 2 days. I said, fuck that.
You said what?
I fasted for like 2 days. I said, fuck that.
That was it?
Yeah, I got sleep apnea. And high blood
eat.
Pressure.
So you got to eat.
I got to take my meds, bro. I want to die out here.
This nigga's crazy.
I tried. Hey, I tried.
No, he said he going to pray for us. I'm going to pray for y'all.
Hey, Ak, I tried, bro. I gave y'all a good 2 days.
You gave who a good 2 days, bro?
Gave him a good 2 days. I fast.
Who you give 2 days to?
I gave Allah a good 2 days.
Yo, get your man.
He knows my heart. He knows my heart. You know I tried.
Yo, you said Allah like God and Allah ain't the same person, bro.
They not.
What? Yo, get you. Hey, Ak, get your man. Yo, what's happening today on the No Man program? Get your mans, bro.
So
man, this nigga's crazy.
But I'm playing. Like,
nah, it's all good. Nah. But look, I
gave us a sense of humor, right?
Nah, that's true. Yeah.
June, yo, what's good, my boy?
June, what's good, bro? Hey, yo, listen, are we talking a little bit of sports today? Bro, June, don't come up here like fucking with us, bro. We ain't talking sports that much, I think. You know what I'm saying? Access sleep disease. Why fast? Why you woke, nigga?
Nah, nigga, I can't breathe. You hear the congestion?
June be checking in thinking niggas about to talk sports, man.
We is. We gonna talk sports just because you up here.
Yeah. Big up the off the top sports. You know, right here on A Squad Rubber Radio.
Yo, hey, June, y'all need to.
That was crazy.
Hey, yo, you need to change the name of your show. Off the top, that's crazy wild.
You said, wait, y'all talking sports off again? Come on, top. Bro. We not. Come on, bro. Go ahead, Joe. Go ahead, bro. You gotta relax, bro.
Hey, Joe, we talk about everything up here. So, you know, you might get some sports. You might get some political stuff. You might get some way out crazy.
Yeah. No. You know what? I did. We gonna talk about it. It's sports, but it ain't sports. That nigga Jalen Green is wildin', bro. He wildin', bro.
Wildin'.
Your man is wildin', bro.
Speaking of sports, right? Speaking of sports.
Hey, oh, yo, look, he put Paul. Yo, Lil Diddy. That's a topic, bro. We gotta talk about that.
Oh yeah, we gonna talk about that. Hey, Joe. See, if you was following the show, you would know what I'm about to say, and I'm happy that Kentucky got eliminated from the NCAA playoffs because them niggas be wilding in Kentucky. Now they can go home and kiss their cousin.
Yeah.
Fucking guys in Kentucky is crazy, bro. Shout out to, Kentucky about it. Glad they lost. Wow.
Yeah, man. So, you know, I worked 67 hours this week, bro.
67.
You know what I'm saying? Give me all my fucking coins, huh? No.
67?
No. I mean, yesterday, because I had no, how my shit set up is, I had no more hours left to work Saturday. So it was like, yo, go home, get some rest, bro. Like, why are you trying to, you know what I'm saying?
Thank you, I appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Appreciate you.
Joe, appreciate you, bro. For real. You know what I'm saying? One of my favorite shows on the station. Yeah, man, let the folks know, man, you know what I'm saying? So what are we going to do? You got anybody to shine a light on?
Yeah. I want to shout out you know that it's National Women's Month.
Okay.
Yeah.
Talk about it.
We're going to shout out all the women out there, you know, all the women, not just one. All of them. Even if you're doing bad, you're still a woman. It'll get better. It'll get great at the end, trust me. You know what I'm saying? You just got to do what you got to do. If you're a snooze ball, be the best snooze ball you're going to be. If you're a great woman, continue being great. We don't judge here. We just going to talk about you. That's
it. Yeah, and we take all the smoke, especially if you're cooking.
Especially if you're cooking, you know. We don't discriminate. Nobody's safe for this show. Yeah. Nobody. Not even us. We're not safe.
Nobody.
we put rap on the screen a couple of times, you know?
Oh, I live on the screen. them niggas, I can't do nothing. I can't do anything. Take a look.
It's in the book. Yo, that was a good show.
Nah, it was fire, but you know.
Reading Rainbow, you know, was a good show.
You know, black people, we kill everything, bro. We kill everything off.
That's crazy.
Once we stop making it cool, they take it down.
No, it's called the No Man Scream, baby.
Yeah, the No Man Scream. He said, "Oh, Joe said nobody's safe, not the Summer Jam Scream." Now, yeah, it's called the No Man Scream. Get it
before you go on the screen, nigga. It's called the no ma'am screen. You know what I mean, don't be the next victim. I'm a repeat offender. Yeah, man. So it's a couple of lights I want to shine. I want to shine a light on Avion Crockett, comedian.
What he did?
So, I mean, he made a movie called a hip hop story. It's a comedy movie, and you know he do like the impersonations. So he dress up as Hov, Kanye, like everybody that he impersonate in the movie is, and it's. He put it in theaters on February 24th, but it was select theaters, and it's still in theaters now. I'm not sure if it's down in Newark. I'm not sure, but
Cityplex don't got it.
If you want to be entertained and you love hip hop and you love like the legends, this nigga he goes crazy. So I wanted to shine a light on him.
Okay,
it's called a hip hop movie. If it's in your area, a hip hop story. It's a comedy movie by Avion Crockett. Okay. If it's in your theaters, please go see it. You know what I'm saying? And the second light I want to shine on is Nas. Nas, the legend. So, Nas, government named Nasir Jones, has teamed up with Mark Canton, the producer of 50 Cent's Power, for a series based on the life and victories of Brooklyn's Maurice Ashley, who became the first international chess grandmaster. This was back in 1999.
Okay.
So he's putting together, he's developing a series based on this, on this guy. You know what I'm saying? So if you're a chess player, you will love this. You know what I'm saying? So definitely tune in. You know, do your homework on that because it's on the way. But I just wanted to shine a light on those guys, and that's it. You know what I'm saying?
I play a little bit of chess here and there.
Okay.
Word.
All right. Yeah, man. So it's the No Man program. We're going to get into some music. The intro we played, that was Abyss. That joint was called Pieces. That's what we played in the intro. But we about to get into some music, and then we're going to come back with some leftovers. You know what I'm saying? Got this J Wonder In My Own Way loaded up. And it's available on all music platforms. So right here on A-Squad Rebel Radio. We'll be right back.
A-SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
Yeah. I like this shit. All right. I feel like I get in my own way. I can't find a kick to save myself. I can't help it. I can't help it.
Yeah.
This shit is so surreal, I'm not the victim, that's why I'm writing these wrongs. Refuse to sit in silence, I'll speak up before I'm gone. Cause my actions wasn't reasonable, word to the brother Sean. But without a doubt, I'll straighten it out, let's move along. Ayo, my demons wanna test me, but I won't fail. Try to bargain with me, want my soul that I won't sell. Phone calls from Zoe ain't getting no bell. So shiz and driller sat and cooked the formula at the top floor of the motel. We sleeping on this, oh well. Don't you get discouraged, they do it all. Without a four-leaf clover, we'll ball out, that's worth the boss. Celebrate my wins with the same ones I took a loss. Right. It's TME and EBF till they bury my coffin. Yeah. And I'm sending all my love to the South for holding me down. You used to talk shit, look at him now. But what do I get from being bitter? Yeah. I'm still a winner, I got a letter from my heart, I know they'll all remember.
I feel like I get in my own way, I can't find a kick to save myself. I can't help it. I can't help it.
Yeah.
I feel like I get in my own way. I can't find a kick to save myself. I can't help it.
All right.
I can't help it.
Yeah. Locked in, I ain't taking no breaks. They said it ain't healthy, I need the rest. Boy, you fading away, but working is the only way. Energy getting me paid. I'd rather see brothers working and flourish than catching a case. I pick the lane, but you can never box me in, cause bitch, we not the same. If opportunity never knocks, I build a door and make a way. They said we need you, know what that means. My words can cure them vaccines, and not the free shit they using to
kill.
I
feel like I get in my own way. I can't find a kick to save myself. I can't help it. I can't help it.
Yeah.
I feel like I get in my own way. I can't can't find a cape to save myself. I can't help it. I can't help it.
Yeah.
RebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
Check, check. Mike. You know what I'm saying? We are back. It's the No Man program right here on A Squad Rebel Radio. You know what I'm saying? Yo, what is happening right now? What's going on?
Zay said some wild shit.
Yeah, man. That was Jay Wonder with In My Own Way. You know what I'm saying? Available on all music platforms. And we are back. Johnny Doe, you got any leftovers, brother? Oh, first off, big up the Blues 360. Just walked in the building. You know what I'm saying? It's my guy. You know what I'm saying? The Bally Hour. You know what I'm saying? Right here on A-Squad Rubber Radio. You know what I'm saying?
It is a leftover, because we was about to talk about what Putin did.
What who?
What Putin did.
Putin.
Hey, Sada, what's going on?
You said Putin?
Putin.
Oh,
little
Putin.
Nigga from Russia.
Oh, Cuzzo, what's up, yo? What's the word?
So this, I ain't even mad at him.
Yeah, so he, we had leftovers. So yeah, what did he do?
Well, basically what he did was he said that the Alphabet people was an extreme terrorist group. And he ain't having that shit. So he put the ultimate pause on the Alphabet people. He said that is not allowed in his country.
He said the ultimate pause?
The ultimate pause. He said he's not having that shit.
Oh, my
He said
God.
There ain't no Diddy in going on in Russia.
Oh.
Basically.
Oh, my God.
He said that's an extremist terrorist group. Extremist group. And not only will you get in jail for it, he's freezing your bank accounts. And he put you in jail. So he's going to take your money, and he going to lock you up. That is wild.
Yeah, that's wild. Well, you know how they treat stuff like that in America. But, like, you know, I think everything outside of America is a dictatorship. I don't think – I could be wrong.
Yeah, because
like, – I could be wrong because it feels like – because – it just feel I'm one of them people who believe like other countries don't know how to govern.
How do you think these niggas know how to govern?
No, I don't think they do either. But I think
they worse.
No. I think you got to pick. You ever heard the phrase the lesser of the evils?
Yes.
I think America is the least of the evils.
Nah, bro. It's some,
still evil, but I think they the least.
It's some places that it's some countries that like they help pay these people right across the board. They get them type of stimuluses to survive, and it just some places is better.
Yeah, right. I only mentioned that because I think like over here, the community would be outraged, like the Alphabet community, they'd be outraged.
Yeah, but
over there, I think like govern laws like the laws in the government is completely different. So they kind of like,
cause they
oh, there's nothing
ass.
They can.
Like they'll whoop your ass. Like, are you opposing? Oh, okay, we got something for you. They gonna beat the shit out of them. Like, it ain't. I'm not saying it's right, but
yeah, right.
It's just like that's the way they govern. Mm-hmm. Like, we not having that.
Mm-hmm.
And here, it's just different here.
Yeah.
It's like it got to the point where they change shit because they don't want to hurt somebody's feelings. Oh okay. Well, somebody's feelings always gonna get hurt.
Right.
Truth hurt.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And instead of y'all trying to be like, okay, you can do it, and you forcing it upon people, let people make the choices that they want or they own.
Yeah. Okay.
You know?
I can vouch for that.
So that's why Putin like, man, look, I'll make the decision for y'all. Ain't happening. Don't let me find out.
Yeah, that's wild. Yeah, that's wild.
All right, so folks want to check in, let us know y'all thoughts on that, you know what I'm saying, as we move along. You know, we'll talk right back to you. Y'all know how we do it.
You don't have leftovers?
Yeah, you know me, bro. I'll be clipped up. You know what I mean? You know we going to talk Donald Trump. You know what I'm saying? We going to talk Donald Trump.
Where Blue go? Ooh, yeah, go ahead. Say what you got to say.
Yo, yeah, no, we gonna talk Donald Trump, because we got to talk about what was going on in New York, yo. I really want to shout out, like, Letitia James, and Attorney General.
She took an L, bro.
Huh?
She took an L.
But hold up. Hold on. You know what I'm saying? Like they initiating proceedings to seize this nigga assets.
But I'm telling you, she took an L. Did you get the update?
Oh, what's the update?
Not happening, Captain.
Oh, what happened?
The Supreme Court blocked that.
Oh, they blocked it?
Yeah, now they ain't got to pay nothing.
He ain't got to pay nothing? That might be leftovers. I got to look into that.
Go ahead.
Leftovers.
$464 million bond, right?
Yeah.
So, according to CNN, like Donald Trump said, he couldn't get it. Mm-hmm. So they said that the assets, his buildings, and all that.
Okay.
And now they said if he can't pay it, so it's just in the proceeding that they blocked it for now. So right now she can't go after it right now.
Right. Well, you know he got till Monday to pay, right?
Yeah, he got till Monday to pay.
So that's probably the hold off then, because she's initiating the proceedings to seize it. Didn't say that's what's gonna happen. Like, they in the process of making it happen, according to what I saw. You know what I'm saying? But he got till Monday to pay. So, like, we'll wrap that up until next week. Maybe that'll be leftovers for next week. You know what I'm saying? But did you see that his campaign donations, they're trying to, like, authorize permission to use campaign donations for him to pay the fraud bond? You know that?
Yeah.
Did you see that? Now, my take on that is, they wouldn't have let somebody like Obama do that, or any Democratic president. They wouldn't be. They would be like, oh, because you know it's all chess. It's all do as I say, not as I do, with them. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I could do it, but you can't. You see what I'm saying? They would not be cool with a president like Clinton or Obama or even Biden. They'd be trying to crucify them for the shit that they're allowing for their party. You see what I'm saying? Because, again, like I said, when you have influence, I think we talked about this on one of our previous episodes. When you have influence, like, people will do any and everything, no matter how guilty you look or may not be, to make sure that you are exonerated. Like they gonna do that from jump. That's just what it is. That's why I think, like, you could be good at something or great at something, but when you have influence at something, it's better than what you're capable of. They just like, oh my gosh, everything you do is great. You got influence. Influence is wild. It's like that. You know what I'm saying? So, but like I said a few episodes ago, like, regardless of what they do to this motherfucker, because we are America, Trump is going to win office. He has to win office. I'm not saying it because I want him to win, but that's just how we set up. The nigga is going to win. Ain't nobody dumb. The nigga's going to win. Come on, bro. Think about it. Look how the laws work. RICO. Like, all that shit. Oh, no. Look at when somebody died during another crime. Them four police officers during the insurrection, I talk about this all the time. They died. They lost their life, and Trump got off, and he incited that shit. And he got off.
But the other people went to jail, though.
But the other people went to jail. But, yeah, y'all go, but not him. He can't go. You know what I'm saying? So that was my leftover. That was definitely my leftover. But, oh no, I do got one more leftover, because we did talk about Diddy, and then I seen a couple of posts. So the new trend is not pause. The new trend is no Diddy.
All
Johnny Doe, why is the new, what is it about this new trend? It's little niggas say pause, no Diddy. No Diddy. Not pause, no Diddy. Just say no Diddy.
Yeah, no Diddy. It's just like, because you ain't with that freaky shit. Like, oh, yeah, you wild and you freaky as hell. No Diddy. But I,
where does it originate from, Johnny Doe?
What, the no Diddy?
Yes. your perspective, where does it originate from?
I forgot who the first one that said it. Matter of fact, I don't know who the first person that made it public, but it don't really matter. Because I just say no freaky. Like, it's mm-hmm. no freaky for me.
Mm-hmm.
But that mm-hmm. no Diddy shit is wild. Like,
no, that's, they just made it trendy. Like, that's,
yeah, it's trendy.
Can you, that's wild. And then now all of these new, like, these old interviews that he did, and he say certain shit, and they, like, compiling it together. Yo.
I'm saying.
And it's crazy. Like, hey, as a moral fan of Pop Diddy's music. Niggas. As a moral fan of his music, I don't listen to it the same no more.
So, I'm going to be honest. Pop told y'all niggas he was freaky.
He said Pop told y'all?
Pac and Shook Knight told y'all niggas he was freaky. I don't know. Like, you ever notice, like, how he called Big or going back to Cali? He said, yo, we going back to Cali, baby. Get up. He woke that nigga up like he was his bitch.
It was 6 in the morning. We got money to get.
Nah, see how he called him, though?
He called him.
Yeah, he called him like, yo, Big, get up.
I'm up, man.
What up? What's up? We going to Cali, baby.
LAX. We flying to LAX.
Word.
Cali?
No doubt. Look how he said it.
Yeah.
He called and said, he was like, yeah, I'm about to fly you out.
Yo, you a QAnon conspiracy theorist, bro. Say, you a QAnon.
He flew him out. He flew him out to Cali.
Yo, they buy. Is Johnny Doe a conspiracy? Is a QAnon conspiracy theorist?
Nah, I just make stuff make sense.
Let us know.
I just make stuff make sense. Like, you see the. And then, like, on. And big delivery on, like, who the fuck is this? Page me at 5:46 in the morning. He was mad about that. But when Puff called him at 6, he was just like, I'm up. I'm up, baby. He wasn't mad. He had no.
You the dumbest nigga I know. Did you do that?
He ain't do that to Pop for the. He do that for Pop for the barbershop. Why ain't get mad at Pop for the barbershop? Who had an intricate plot?
Yo,
you know what I mean? Why ain't get mad at Pop for the barbershop?
Yo, you shot the fuck out, bro.
He like, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, you shot the fuck out.
Hey, yo, hey, Ack, he did. He flew him out. He flew him out to Cali.
Oh my
gosh. Hey, yo.
Don't you know, Ack is a bad, I know Ack is hurt the most over this whole situation. Because Ack is a bad boy fanatic. You know what I'm saying?
Word, you see that? You do that bass cover.
Hey, listen, as long as you wasn't at the parties, bro, we heard about the parties. We were never there.
Ack had a shiny suit like Mace.
You said what?
Ack had a shiny suit like Mace. That's his favorite bad boy artist. Love Mace.
Yo, if I'm Mace right now, I would just like start extorting Diddy for all the money he owed me right now.
He,
like,
paid him back.
You think he ain't got stories? I know it's more. That's he paid him a little bit. He owed. I'm pretty sure it's. Think about it. Think about the money that they made. Think about the money that Puff made off of Mace. Because you understand, Mace was really hot. That Harlem World album sold millions of records.
Yeah.
So think about everybody that got paid and the pennies that artists get. If I was Mace, I'd start extorting that nigga right now, bro. I ain't even gonna lie. He said, no parties, no parties. Yo.
Hey, yo.
Nigga, you was dead.
You was dead.
Hey, yo, how far back we go, bro? You know something, nigga. You was dead. You was dead, bro.
Hey, yo. Yo, whoever. Yo, anybody to check in ever got flued out?
You said what?
I got flued out.
What's happening right now?
That's why I know they got flown out. Just saying. Shit.
Yo, you gotta relax.
Yo, if a girl ever offered to fly you out?
I've been flown out plenty of times in life.
You get So you out here just getting
You asked the check-in. Now you asking me now.
Cause you just,
for the record, I'm not on the check-in. I'm at the show. You asked, I answered. Now you got more. It's a dub, bro.
No.
We ain't doing that.
No. So you got flown out. Was you obligated to get?
Obligated to what? What you asking me?
Like, what you do for that flight? Because you got flown out.
What you mean?
You did something strange because you got flown out?
You said what?
You did something strange because you got flown out?
Did I do something strange?
Yeah, you said you got flown out a bunch of times.
Next question.
Oh, this nigga. Yeah, that nigga a bad bitch. <You said what? laughs> Nigga's a bad bitch. Yeah, he got flown out. He got flown out.
You're terrible. Just so you know, you're terrible.
So that's what he be going, talking about. We going to see a Raiders game. Yeah, all right, bitch. You get flown out. Yeah, I'm going out with my Laker family. Yeah, all right, nigga.
Don't laugh at this guy. LC Musin, don't laugh.
Oh, shit.
Y'all don't laugh at him. This is not fun.
Yo, shit. I hate it, man. Shit.
You said what?
I ain't mad at you, bro.
Hold on. Axe said, nigga, sassy. Come, all right.
Hey, Axe, you can't get mad because the nigga got flown out, man. Damn, man, I wish I get flown out. Shit.
What are we talking about right
getting
now?
Getting flown out, nigga. That's what you talking about. You talking about getting flew. How they say it? Flewed out? We getting flewed out, like.
Nigga said, we getting flewed out.
Yo, shit. But that's another episode. Bro.
This that's another episode.
Yeah, that's another episode.
Oh, because
that
God.
Nigga got flued out.
I think it's time for a song. We did some leftovers.
Oh, man.
When we come back.
Was it first class? You get flew out first class?
You said what?
You got flown out first class?
Bro, you doing the most.
I just want to know, bro.
No, I didn't get flown out first class. Oh, they
yeah,
do that?
He did.
Oh, I need to step my shit up, man.
He did. No,
he said,
you said it.
He said, I've been flewed out
plenty of times.
I'm crying. I said that?
Yeah, because you said asked. Plenty of times.
But you asked.
Plenty of times. Like, it ain't just one or twice. He said that with confidence. Like, yo, I got flown out plenty of times. So he just out here getting flown out, giving up. He out there giving it. That. You sure you ain't got no children
Yo, cuz. Hold on. First off, cuz, like, you ain't supposed to be, like, we really family. You do know that, right?
Yeah.
Like, I know all of y'all. I mean, we ain't met, but I know all of y'all. I've been around a long time. Cuzzo, don't be laughing, bro.
That like, nigga out there giving it up for the trip. That's how your game tickets got paid for, huh?
My what?
Your game ticket. He ain't pay for that shit.
Yo,
cap.
I hate niggas. Look at that
package.
Nigga said that
word.
Thought package. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we got to get into some music. I don't want to talk anymore. Jamina Denae, this joint is called Unicorn. When we come back, we going to get straight into the Black Father Farm. You know what I'm saying? The Black Father Farm is next right here on the No Man Program. Ladies, we take all the smoke, especially if you're cooking. Everything is on the table right here on 8 Squad Rebel Radio. We'll be right back.
Yo, listen. 8SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
It's just different.
Well, let me all of my mental. I'm from the trenches. We ain't the same. Been what I've been through. Left me on red. I left for them, and it's really that simple. Now I'm too lit. All of my shit, design is original. Been facts, I never been fictional. Now that we live in the digital. Niggas ain't loyal, everybody ain't for it. We live in conditional. Ain't like them hoes who fuck all the bros, man, it's all about principle. I never met one nigga in love with a coochie that's visible. Ass shake, click, bait, no Insta. Set my team on in my business. High as the clouds, I never come down green, purple like Grimace. Give my kids everything, my nigga, everyday Christmas. I live in a rational, my nigga, everyday business. I am down to go down in the Guinness. I am a unicorn, my nigga, I am a unicorn. Money my uniform, my nigga, money my uniform. You have been misinformed, my nigga, what kind of shit you want? I am a unicorn, my nigga, I am a unicorn.
And I'm living my life with a passion. Blood in the air for the soldiers who fell before we could ash it. I'm feeling myself, don't need no one else to come with no ass kiss. I'm back on my bully, the fuck on the dash, let's stack up these caskets. Kicking back in spectacular fashion, I'm looking at y'all in the rearview. inside me is still new. Throwing that ass in a circle called Benjamin Franklin the monsoon. I'm making it rain like a typhoon. Been through the trap at the minimum, man, shit was pitiful. Now I'm on top like the pinnacle. Pattern my styles from criminals who live by principle. We're not the same or identical. You search for fame in your interviews, I find it difficult. My thoughts are incomprehensible to individuals who are concerned with the cynical. I leave it all on my inner loop.
I am a unicorn, my nigga, I am a unicorn. Money my uniform, my nigga, money my uniform. You have been misinformed, my nigga, what kind of shit you want? I am a unicorn, my nigga, I am a unicorn.
SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
Hey, Sada, you're right. Nobody's safe. Nobody's safe.
He's not safe.
All right. So we are back. That was Jamina Dene. That joint is called Unicorn. Please add that to your playlist. If you into making playlists like me, every song that is on this show, please add it to your playlist. You know what I'm saying? I know everybody want to hear Beyonce. We don't play Beyonce up here. We play the indies, the dope indie artists from all over the place. You know what I'm saying? Of course, it starts in our yard right here in Jersey, but we play everybody. So if you're an artist and you have dope music that you just want to, you know, break on our platform, send it over. You know what I'm saying? But it can't be no bullshit because I'm the music guy. If it's trash, I'm not. Don't fuck up my, like, don't fuck up our platform with your trash, all right?
Nah, you can do it.
Wait. Shit. Let's drop the bomb. What?
Send that shit.
What's going to happen?
We going to talk about you. But you going to get some spins because we going to keep playing that shit and we going to critique the fuck out that song. And then we gonna throw it in the trash. I'm make sure that shit ain't on nobody else's database. We gonna go through everybody's shit. Erase it.
Oh, man. All right, man. So it is now time for the Black Father Farm. So let's get into it. So for those of y'all that's watching for the first time, the Black Father Farm is, you know, issues that we as men talk about as fathers, you know what I'm saying, that fathers can relate to, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So it seemed like, you know, with black fathers, child support is always a thing, right? It's always a thing. How many times this should have been, it could have been a leftover. How many times have we talked about child support reforming, motherfuckers that get locked up for it, athletes that be knocking motherfuckers up knowing they about to get the big contract? But this one is a little different. We gonna go into the Wayans family. Let me ask you real quick. Yeah. Who is your favorite Wayans? I got a list of a few. I love all of them, don't get me wrong, but who's your favorite Wayans? Mine is Damon. That's my nigga.
Yeah.
Like my wife and kids,
a little bit.
And his name was Mike. That's my name too. That shit was. I'm like, this nigga is me. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, so who? Yeah, look, Cuzzo said Damon. But who's your favorite Wayans?
I like Damon, but I like Marlon too.
Yeah, and it's crazy you mentioned that because we gotta talk Marlon Wayans. We gotta talk Marlon. That nigga, he's stupid. We love Marlon. We bro.
I ain't gonna say he's stupid.
No. When I say stupid, I mean comedy stupid. Oh, come on, bro. Yeah. What you thought I meant?
Like dumb. What you about to talk about?
Well, he is dumb for what I'm about to talk about.
Oh man.
So Marlon Wayans is suing. His ex girlfriend is suing for more child support for their 15 month old daughter. He is currently paying $18,000 a month. Now, I seen the chick. His baby mother is bad. Like, bad. But that's not the point. Because I don't care how good a chick look. Bruh, you got to know your position in life. But who knows what these chicks be saying to niggas. Like, why they making the baby. No, that's a real thing. Who knows what a chick be saying? Because after the baby get here, shit get different.
It don't be the words, bro. It be that little grip shit. Like, you just be like,
oh, you mean the box?
Yeah.
On the box?
Yeah. You just like, you're not pulling out.
Yeah, these chicks be working their legs out. Cuzzo, Cuzzo, let me ask you a question. You right here on the check-in. These chicks be working their legs out, Cuzzo.
That grip.
Just throw me some fire emojis if they be working their legs out, because a chick that work her legs out, bro, you got to ask yourself life questions, bro.
What 1 year? Yo, that's the thing. Like, no 1 year old needs 18K a month.
No, we was going to get to that. I just wanted to be a jerk.
Oh, no.
What 1 year old needs 18K a month? Nobody.
Nobody.
Nobody needs 18K a month as a kid. We don't need that. That's beyond. Ask a 1 year old what they need right now. I'm going to be a jerk now. Ask a 1 year old what they need right now.
Well, since Cuzzle I'm an expert,
said not the grip. Y'all got to stop that excuse.
It's the
come
grip.
On, no,
that's grippy shit.
Cuzzo, listen. This is the No Man program. You know what you tune into every Sunday at 2 o'clock. Don't do that. This is a real thing. Some niggas slip off the grip. That's the you niggas stop slipping off the gripping, bro.
Words.
Stop slipping off the gripping. Listen, I'm gonna say this, bro. Listen. Yeah. If you a man and you inspire to be anything, let me talk my shit real quick. This is for Marlon Wayans. This is for Zion Williamson. This is for Jalen Green. All them niggas.
Tyreek Hill.
You say what?
Tyreek Hill.
Him too. This nigga smashed a cigarette or a cigar in his baby mother face and told her his wife face and told her to sign a prenup. Listen, all you niggas that inspire to be something better than the average nigga that's working 9 to 5. And no, this is for every man. Not trying to downplay or make levels to this shit. Listen, bro, if you know where you going, bro, you can't just be shooting off, bro. You can't, bro. You cannot, bro. Stop. Relax. Like, chill out, bro. 18 bands, though. 18 fucking bands for a kid. A 1 year old. Nigga, children's place, motherfucker. An outfit is like $8. You get a whole outfit for like $12 at children's place, nigga. But that's children's place. These niggas trying to get fucking
Gucci,
you right.
Cartier.
Maybe these niggas just above my pay grade. So that's why 18,000 makes sense.
Yeah, but yo, she
nah,
makes
fuck
bank.
Out of here. She make bank, but she trying to secure. Like, come on, bro. 18,000?
For expenses, for my monthly expenses.
And no, and don't get me wrong. Maybe Marlon got it. Because here's the thing. And it's some real shit. If I can do more comfortably, I would do it. Comfortably. Not just, that's what it is. If I could just comfortably give up 18 bands, I'd be like, whatever.
But he said that.
Bitch.
He said he's not complaining about it, but then you want 20,000 a month?
That's wild. I mean, if you think of the context, like for the kid, that's wild. That's wild.
But her list was like, I got $3,000 in groceries, and I see the child care, $5,000. You probably gotta get a daddy or something. But the $3,000.
I mean,
what
she do? Because I just know
she's a surgeon or some shit like that. She work in the medical field.
Like she a surgeon.
Something like that. I know she work in the medical field.
Oh, the bitch got a career.
Yeah, she make $200,000 a month.
So she ain't just laying down. All right, it's different. No, don't get me wrong. Listen, to the hardworking women, like, I'm not going to knock. I still think 18,000 is crazy, regardless.
That's
I'm not
insane.
Saying don't give nothing, but... I mean, she a surgeon. She ain't like lazy. Like, I got, you know what I'm saying? She like, I do shit.
That's why I said the $5,000 in child care ain't that bad. But you asking for 18K a month.
Okay. So you know what? Let me lay off Marlon a little bit. We gotta lay off Marlon a little bit. Cause it ain't like it's some chick with nothing. Like she. Like she do something, she about something, but and nobody knows what the arrangement was, what it was, if they was dating, if they try, like we don't know, and that could backfire on a man at any moment, at any time. You know what I'm saying? It don't work out, now you owe. You
What's
know what
up
saying?
With the condoms? Niggas don't use condoms.
Look. Cuzzo said, "All right, let me be Sharif from Menace to Society for a minute. What's up with the condoms?
Niggas don't use condoms." I guess what you make over a certain amount, confidence is out the question.
No, listen, Cuzzo, you, you right. But my thing is, was they in a relationship or was that baby mother now? Because if I'm a nigga, like, if I'm any one of the Wayans, anything that says Wayne says longevity. It says legacy. It says I did the work. It says I'm here now. So if I'm a Wayans, I'm protecting everything. So we don't know the basis of their relationship. He probably could have no, because listen, he probably could have felt like I'm a married, like I'm a, take me for personal, right? My middle child is 16 years old. Mm-hmm. I was done with kids after him. Mm-hmm. Done. Like, I'm done up. My daughter is only here because I got married. Not because I wanted more kids, because I got married.
Son, that's crazy, bro.
So who knows what their situation was?
We about to be, like, in our 40s, so you got to think.
About to be? Nigga, we here now. What the fuck is you talking? We ain't going to lie to the people. Nigga, we here now. I'm 40. I turned 41 last month, nigga. I'm a old nigga. My oldest son is 20. I'm a grandfather, nigga.
Fuck what you talking about? Like I said,
nigga, you older than me. You older than me, bro.
I have military age. I'm young.
So. I got military. Yo,
so
get, yo,
like I said,
yo, act, get your homie, bro.
We almost in our 40s, and yo, we gonna be like 50 taking our kids to kindergarten. Yo, be like 50 going to like first grade. Like, yo, that's crazy.
Oh, no, well, see, by the time I'm 50, my daughter will be in fucking, wait, how old is she now? She 4? So she about to be 5 this June. So by the time she go to high school, I'll be like 52 or 53 or something. My math ain't working. Don't judge me. What's in this cup? Dough hiding his age. Grow up, bro. We here now, nigga.
Grow up.
We here now.
Grow up. You see what happened to Toys R Us when they grew up? They went out of fucking business. Fuck he talking about grow up. No, nigga.
Yeah.
Throw away. Elvis,
huh? Word, right? Talk some grow up. Hell no, you ain't learned from Toys R Us, nigga.
Oh, man. Crazy, bro.
Niggas went out of business.
Crazy. Oh, man. So, yeah, man. So moving along, we still at the Black Father phone. Yo, peep this shit out, right?
All right.
Imagine gambling. Right, so let's talk FanDuel real quick. I didn't even know FanDuel had this kind of access. Peep this shit. Imagine, watch this. Imagine you got $2 in your pocket. Well, this is a real story. You got $2 in your pocket. You hit off a parlay. You make $1,500.
Oh yeah,
and child support. Take that shit.
Ah, I pay your fucking child support.
FanDuel, somehow, some way, child support got a hold of it and took it. No, how does that? No, FanDuel, I got questions.
Choice, what up?
Yo,
because they fed
press to be the best. What's Choice. Good, my guy? Choice. Oh, press to be. See, he's some artist shit. I knew that was some artist shit. Press to be the best. That's all right, nigga. All right, bro. Choice, what up, customs, my guy? Love your life, nigga. Needs, what up? Huh?
For your custom needs.
Yeah.
Press to be the best.
Yeah. Yeah, so, no, so you, $2, your last two. Let's say it's your last two, and you hit 15, and they take what you make, and it, like, what you doing?
Shut up at my baby mother house. Bitch, gave my 1,500. I'm broke. Us, real rap. I'm showing up. Like, yo, look. I spent my last $2. I ain't got nothing. I got nothing. 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 Hit it with the Whitney. Like, yo.
Yo, listen, as a man who's once was on child support before,
like on paper, yo, like it's being taken from you.
How does it feel like we off child support?
Off child support?
Yeah.
How does it feel? It's brilliant. It but is? I had to.
Wait.
Listen, I had to see my oldest. They young men now, so they understand certain stuff, and they just like me, like in certain areas, like they not beat. Like, yo, make this make sense. It made no sense for me to ever be on child support. You know what I'm saying? So thank God that I got off before they was old enough to ask questions. You know what I'm saying? But, yo, that shit is the worst, bro. Oh, my gosh. It's the worst. Especially, he said, too late for me.
Hey, Jim, yo.
Ouch.
It's never too late, bro.
What, too late for me to do what?
You gonna be off child support? Oh. Nah, never too late, bro.
You can't escape the rape.
Nah, bro, government gonna get they money.
Nah, they gonna know. They when they on you, they swarm you. That's what kids said.
For real. Yo, son.
Yo, listen. When they on you, they swarm you. You must never forget.
Son, I was switching jobs before I went to the state. So I was in Integrity House, and then I switched to the state. So, yo,
wait,
I was.
You on?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So
bro, you envy me a little bit.
A little bit. Fuck you. I hope you go back on child support, nigga. And they give you all the arrears.
Yo, go ahead. Tell your shit. Yeah, we gonna talk the arrears after this. Hey, go ahead.
So I was down. Bro, I was good. I was good. Yo, so I went from zero, me on like zero to arrears. I was good. I was current. Bro, I got to the state. I missed like 2 weeks. I'm lying. Let's say 2 months. Bro, how that shit went up to like $4,000 in the rears? I said, yo, nigga, you motherfuckers, are you serious?
Yo, let me tell you. Yo, Choice said to get off. I'm the president, but they ain't getting nothing from me. I've been ducking from them. I've been ducking them for 30 joints.
Yo, nigga, God, you still got a license, nigga?
God, please, no.
Cuzzo laughing at them. Yo, don't laugh. Yo, that shit hurt. Don't laugh. Yo, let me tell you. This is how the arrears happen. The moment she start talking, the moment she file, that's when they start. A lot of niggas don't know this. Listen, fellas. The minute you get served with the paperwork, just go ask how much you owe. Because if you wait for the court date, you wait for them to stamp it, nigga, you're going to be down 2 bands. Trust me. I know. Please.
Let me see.
The minute you know, it's a comedian. He say, the minute you say, well, bitch, fuck you too, a computer start typing your name before the motherfucker even file. Nigga, you be down, nigga. Get your ass down there. Ask questions. So as soon as you walk away, you better be ready to pay. That's the slogan. As soon as you walk away, be ready to pay.
And the shit don't make no sense. The math ain't mathing.
You niggas gotta relax, nigga. You shoot the club up if you want. It's all right. You gonna have to pay that bill. He said, I was off till I got divorced. Damn.
Damn.
Damn. Joyce said, he said, I still do everything and take care of moms. Fuck them. They don't even supposed to be taking child support anyway. Go look into it. Facts. Cuzzo said, nah, I feel y'all pain. I got 3 brothers and cousins. I know. And feel for dudes like y'all that would actually pay if given a chance. Yo, listen. Nigga, where I'm at now, see, you understand. I got put on child support when I was like 25. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've been on it forever. Almost, you know what I'm saying? 20 years.
I was paying.
20 years.
You know what I'm saying? And then it like some stuff happened. You know, she wanted to make a goofy move, and I was like, oh, I had, you know, because you got to, like, even when you paying child support, there's still rights for you. So you got to know your rights. So it's certain stuff that she couldn't do. So when she wanted to do it, I was like, oh, you want to do that? Okay. So drop that, and you can do that. But when you do that, just know that I'll never be in this situation again. And that was the stipulation. And shit got dropped. It was like, hey, we gonna drop this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit real. But all right, man, it's about 3 o'clock. You know what I'm saying? We like an hour through the show. You know what I'm saying? We gonna keep it pushing. That was the Black Father Forum. Oh, you want, right. So before we go into commercial, we got some more sponsors. Johnny Doe, take them away.
Yeah, we got the second half of the sponsors. So we got Smash Transfers. They got to change that name. That's wild. Smash Transfers. Sound like a porn. Smash Transfers. You can reach them at smashtransfers.com. They are located at 200 South Newman Street, Suite Number 5 in Hackensack, New Jersey. Next, we have Cash Group Life Insurance Agency, Richard Brunson, Agency Manager. He can be reached at 609-372-0852. And last but not least, we have Essex County College, 303 University Ave, Monk, New Jersey. Education is important. Unless you're an entrepreneur, but you still need to be educated being an entrepreneur, but education is important. I just want to let y'all know that.
Facts. You know, and once again, if you are an artist or if you are a business owner, you want to, you know, be a guest on the show as well as promote your brand on the show, you can contact us on by email at nomanprogram@gmail.com. And you can also follow us at no_mam_program on IG. You know, you can inbox us there as well. So, yeah, man. So, we going to get into some music. You know what I'm saying? We got this Hibichi loaded up. It's called Ganja. You know what I'm saying? Ever since I went to Jamaica, bro, I'll be getting torched. You know what I'm saying? Oh, Choice wants to be a guest. Yes, you know what? That can happen. You mean, you know, hit me up, bro. You already know. With that being said, we're going to get into this Hibichi. This joint is called Ganja. And then when we come back, we're going to get into a segment called State Relate Debate. We'll be back.
Yeah, listen. 8SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
Roll up the ganja. Roll up the ganja.
I say we roll up the ganja.
We roll up the ganja. Roll up the ganja. Smoke ganja.
Say we roll up the ganja. I come through like my nut on her face. Like pistachios, I crack it, take this L to the face. After that, then we get lit and slowly hit outer space. Then meet Gazoo, cause he got green and shorty might wanna aim. Like this beat, I easily write her, only rolls up easy. Widers told me, boy, I don't need that, so put that Dutchie away. Police sirens get the ringing, Spidey senses started tingling, cause they smelled that Mary Jane. They had something to say, they said,
roll up the ganja, green buzz like Blanca, dress like a Rasta, hang to my shoulders. We don't smoke that Reggie, but we puffin' on the veggie. Keep the sauce like spaghetti, all I need is Mary Jane. Inhale it, catching planes, smoking gas to turbulence. Weed in my glands, I got brownies and some Zans. That's the trippy kid, we take a trip to Wonderland with hippies. That's the trippy kid, we off the drug. That's the trippy kid, roll up the ganja.
Roll up the ganja.
Roll up the ganja.
Roll up the ganja.
Twerking for the blanca.
I bought an Aussie or that OG sour, that's that headband. Now look how high up in the sky I am, like meth and red man. I'm kinda fried like bacon, wake and bacon. But first give praise to the Most High. Get up, stand up, no lie, no I won't give up the fight. But it's only right that we turn up tonight. So put up your lights, cipher and don't divide. I pass the Dutch heap on the left hand side, then I continue to
roll up the ganja.
Roll up the ganja.
Roll up the ganja.
Roll up the ganja.
Twerking for the blanca.
Yeah, we always having fun, yeah.
Listen, 8SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people. 8SquadRebelRadio.
It's on fire.
Home of the independent artist. The station that gets the block shaking.
Yo, we are back. We are back.
That was He Be Chief featuring Jay Wonder. That joint is called Ganja. It's available on all music platforms. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's time for a segment of State Relate Debate. For those of y'all that are watching for the first time, State Relate Debate is simple. I make a statement. You can either tell me how you relate to it, or if you want to debate why it's wrong, or if you disagree or not. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
So that's what it is. So statement number one, y'all on the check-in, y'all can, you know, share your opinions and, you know, y'all differences. We'll talk about it. Like, everybody's opinion matters up here. You know what I'm saying? With this segment. So the statement says, as little boys, so I guess a man made this statement. It says, as little boys, they taught us to shake off the pain rather than heal. But as men, they taught us you can't heal if you don't reveal. Our teachers failed us. Hashtag men's mental health. I'm going to repeat it. As little boys, they taught us to shake off the pain rather than heal. As men, they taught us you can't heal, they tell us, because at that point you can't teach us. As men, they tell us you can't heal if you don't reveal. Our teachers has failed us. Men's mental health. That's a bit real. Okay. All right. Let's hear your perspective.
I agree with you too. At the end, which says teachers has failed us. It ain't the teachers' responsibility to teach us.
No. But listen. Hold on. Let's go back to the text. If you taught, that means you teach. So it's not about classroom. It's as little boys, they taught us this. We're boys, so we have to learn this. So that means somebody got to teach us this. So it's, I'm not saying like classroom textbook. I'm talking about the, like, the moral context. Like father, uncle, role model on the block, role model Michael Jordan, anybody, whoever we look up to, they taught us something, and they left shit out. So it's not literally classroom. It's more so like, yo, like, how many times did you cut yourself and they said, nah, shake that shit off, get up, nigga, shake it off. You know what I'm saying? Like, they were teaching you to ignore pain. They were teaching you, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then now think about every woman that said, nigga, you ain't shit, you ain't bop, bop, bop. Like, nigga, they was grooming you to be built for the bullshit. But that's my opinion. So I'm kind of like, I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to like paint the premise of how I think about it when I hear it. But like, how do you feel about the context?
Yeah, it makes some type of sense, some sense to it. Because we always like, why you crying for? You're a boy, so don't cry like a girl. You know what I'm saying? You get that all the time. So when you grow, it's like all the trauma and everything you bottle up. And then on the top of that, it's like who do men has to vent to?
Because I'm glad you said that, because it appears that men are not supposed to vent. They're supposed to have it all figured out, because that's society's expectation of you. Think about every nigga that has punched a chick in the face, every nigga that has killed somebody, every motherfucker that killed itself. Like, it be shit going on that society is like, and I'm not making excuses, I'm just telling you. It's, don't get me wrong, like niggas that cheat, right? Every reason that a nigga will cheat, it ain't, you know what I mean? Oh, it said true, it makes sense. Oh,
yeah.
All right, when a black woman say it makes sense, that means we getting through to somebody. Like, it's some real shit going on. Like, don't get me wrong, it's some niggas that cheat because they selfish, they greedy, they gotta have them all, they gotta prove they self. But think about where that trauma comes from. Think about how many the nigga who was told his whole life that he ugly, or he fat, or he can't, he never will, and then he get to a point where he feel like he's the nigga. He gonna abuse any and everybody to their liking, but to him, he just like, I'm doing what everybody told me I couldn't.
Yeah.
I'm fucking the baddest bitches, I'm getting all the money,
underneath all of it, I'm torn, I'm broken, but nigga, to me, I'm living. But y'all looking at me like I'm doing the worst, and I'm not justifying. I'm just telling you how niggas may or may not think. You see what I'm saying? So, like what you teach a young boy is gonna stay with him for the rest of his life. What you show him, and that's the premise of it, it's gonna stay with him for the rest of his life, bro. If your mother or your sister or your, if they told you you ain't gonna be shit, chances are you may or may not. Wanna know why? Because a woman is the first example of what love looks like to you, because you came out of her.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So any and everything that she teach you is gonna, is, and that's why it's careful. Like, that's why I be like, to the women that have sons, how dare you tell him that women are a prize and he was born of you? Your son is a prize too. He's a fucking prize too. He was born of you. That's just like when a motherfucker be like, all right, like, think about it. Mixed babies, right? A white woman get knocked up by a black man. His baby's what?
Biracial.
But society gonna say, oh, that's a nigga. Depends, he came out of a white woman, but yeah, that's a nigga.
Depends on how he act.
Right. But to his face, if he's mixed and he look a little brown, they gonna say, and they see his daddy, they gonna say, or what, whoever the black parent is, vice versa, it could be a white man knocking up a black woman. They're gonna say, that's what it is, right? So look at that. What you install into your kids, whether they're a boy or a girl, I know the context is more so about boys and men, but what you install into your kids, stay with them. So if you a woman with a son, keep telling him, or keep barking at him and telling him he ain't shit. You gonna get the shit he ain't. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, but back to the original context, like, you can't tell a boy his whole life that you can't hear what you don't reveal, and then when he get to become a man, be bothered by how he express himself. You taught him this shit. Society taught him this. Now you like, oh my gosh, you a man now. Reveal it. You're hurting. Motherfucker, I told you I was hurt when I was 6. And you told me to shake it off. Now you telling me you gotta hurry up and reveal it. You know what I'm saying? But that's a perspective that, you know, I could talk about till I'm blue in the face. But that was the statement. So we gonna move on to the next. Cause Johnny Doe is like, nigga, next statement. Please.
Oh, nah,
I know. I'm fucking with you. All right. So on to the next statement. No, that's not it. All right. So the next statement is, hold up. The next statement is kind of similar to that. It says, men who face or have faced emotional abuse are afraid to speak about it because they were taught as young boys to shake off pain. It's the same thing. It's the same thing. It's a fact that will always be downplayed or overlooked. It's a conversation society wants no part of. It's the same thing. Emotional abuse is real.
Yeah.
It's real. Just because you ain't getting, listen, they think physical abuse is, it is the worst case. Don't get me wrong. Physical abuse is real.
But it's real.
Think about how many times a motherfucker just was like, oh, you ain't shit. You ain't. And then they expect it from you.
I'm going to say, I think mental is worse than physical. And I say that because mentally, like you have PTSD for a long time. PTSD, that's mentally, so it's gonna last a lifetime. When you fight, you could get over that. Like, you gonna learn some shit. Like, all right, she like to beat on niggas, all right, whatever. So I know what you gonna do next time. You gonna dip. Oh, you gonna move out the way.
Okay.
But mentally, that shit there forever. So no matter where you go, after you leave her, you gonna go to somebody else, and you gonna have a trigger. So what she did, you gonna be like, oh, that's a trigger. So mentally, mental abuse is far more worse than physical abuse, because those triggers will stay with you forever. And that's why PTSD is real. Like, we could go, we can go, we can fight, we can shoot all day. I'm going to come home. But mentally, you hear loud noise or a pop, you're going to be like, oh, shit, what's that? Because you mentally fucked up. You know?
Yeah. Cuzzo said, I mean, it's life. Speaking as a mother with boys, they fall, they get up, and tough, right? Because you don't want them to be a crybaby. It's like toughen up, chief. But it's true. They learn to hold in that pain. See, Cuzzo, what that is called, that's called accountability. We appreciate, like, women who take accountability. That's fire. That's a real thing. Because that's, like, what she just said is a gift and a curse. You want them to be tough. You want them to get up. You want them to be like, shake it off, because men do have to protect. But what about, like, I say this analogy all the time. If a wild lion walked into a fucking room, he walk in the room, he's a killer. He fucking up everything. But something in the room he softens up to. That's an identity of, I don't have to be a killer all the time. Sometimes I want to cry. Sometimes I want to chill. Sometimes I want to relax. Sometimes I want to be softer. Society don't provide that by the time the boy becomes a man, because he spent so much time building himself to be tough all the time. So when it's time for him to cry, they look at him like he fucking crazy.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? They like, oh, you're not even supposed to be like this. And they disregard. And that's why chicks get beat on. That's why they get cheated on. That's why they, like, you got to take the time to understand that it ain't just you in that relationship with that man. It's him, too. He likes shit. Yeah. He wants shit.
This is what I do with Tyler. Like, when Tyler cries or he catches a little attitude, temper tantrum, mm-hmm. I talk to him like, bro, we ain't doing that. And then on the flip side, I explain to him, like, it's okay to be angry. I don't ever say, oh, you can't be angry. So it's okay to be angry and have your emotions, but your reaction to your emotions is what I don't like.
Yeah.
So if you mad, you start throwing shit and you want to yell. Mm-hmm. Nah, we not doing that.
Right.
And this is why. And I explained to him, like, X, Y, Z, like, you're going to get older. You're going to have daddy not going to be here forever. So you need to learn how to control whatever it is that you can control. And you can always come talk to me. I'm not going, you know what I'm saying? I might joke with you and clown you from time to time, but I'll be serious most of the time, especially if it's something serious. But if it's something like crazy, oh, he get clowned. And only why I do that is to make him tough. Because in school, he used to go, oh, daddy, kids laughing at me. Not, what? Look, bro, we ain't doing that. It's okay. You joke back. You know what I'm saying? And he's always like, well, I'm going to tell a teacher. That's fine, too. But eventually, you got to learn to take up for yourself. Because some teachers ain't going to be like your last teacher. She probably don't even care. She right. And I'll be damned if another grown person tell my son to toughen up.
Right.
Like, bitch, who is you to tell my son
right.
to toughen up?
This is true. This is true.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. No.
I'm not doing that.
No, absolutely. Yeah, it's wild. It's so much shit for grown men to cuss, absolutely got to show them, because life definitely will.
Exactly.
Yeah. I'm going to say this. There is so much to unpack with us as men. And I don't think one of the issues why a lot of black relationships, black marriages fail is because of the condition. Because we're conditioned to not have all these feelings that we have, right? And women aren't conditioned to have the patience for the feelings that we have. Everything dies. Women like, oh, I'm the prize. I get, he has to work for me. And then they grow up and learn like, oh, no, motherfucker, it's two of us. I got shit the same way you got shit. How is it that a man is supposed to protect a girl even when she's grown, but a woman stops nurturing a boy when he becomes a man? let's think about. Nope. Let's go to the next topic. Y'all answer that question on y'all own time. We gonna keep it moving.
It's also over nurturing. Like you see in the Bible boys, they be like 38.
No, it's no such thing as over nurturing. Nope.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. Wanna know why? There's no such thing as over nurturing.
because it's called balance. If you do too much nurturing and not enough discipline, that's where you get that.
It's over nurture, like
yo, that's so, not. It's no such thing so as over nurturing. It is no such thing as over nurturing.
You got your 38-year-old son,
right,
in your house,
right,
not contributing,
right.
Not only to the house, but to society itself.
Okay.
You got to do everything for them.
Okay.
Where's the discipline? Where's...
No, at that point, there is no discipline in no 38-year-old man. It started from the beginning. When he was 12, you should have got him. That's the... See, the discipline comes in the beginning.
So now when you die, so now when that... Like, when his mom died, how he... He's not... He's going to fall apart.
No, no, no. You're right. But however, it ain't from over nurturing. It's under disciplining. You gotta see. Here's the thing: nurturing energy and discipline is a balance. You gotta be. Hey, listen. You gotta be able to love on a kid and then fuck them up at the same time. You gotta be able to do both at a high level. Like, listen. When I love on you, when you do great, do understand that when you fuck up, it's the same energy on the opposite side of the spectrum. Because if you don't balance it, you're going to get the 38-year-old nigga that don't know sugar from shit emotionally. Mm-hmm. And then he just think everything comes to him. You got to balance it. And I'm going to be honest, that's where black culture fucks up at.
Because he's not going to learn. So he going
to... No. Not just black culture. White culture got it
any
worse.
Culture. So you're not going to learn. He's not going to learn how to treat a woman because he going to think that woman is supposed to be his mom. So he's going to sit back and let that woman do everything. Well, I'm the man. You make my bed. You wash my drawers. I don't got to be the mess. I got to wash no dishes. I got to help you. You do everything. And I'm going to sit here and watch you do everything. Take care of the kids. This ain't 1960. Mm-hmm. Like, men got to, you know, we got to show because kids, they look at that. Mm-hmm. So imagine if he has a kid. That kid going to see, well, dad lazy as hell.
No, listen, you're absolutely right. But again...
So the cycle continues.
No, you're absolutely right. But again, look at the spectrum. Watch this. Protect, like, a girl, from the moment she's... from the moment she lets out her first cry, and you see that that's a vagina, to the moment she dies, you are to protect her at all costs.
Yeah.
But a man, a boy... You are to nurture him until he's old enough to become a man, and now all of a sudden he don't need nurturing. Let me explain something to you.
No, I'm not saying
that. No, let me finish. A man needs nurturing from the moment he's born as a boy to the moment he dies. He needs nurturing energy. Society has taught us that when we become men, we don't need that energy anymore, and it's a job that we work for, that we pay for with our muscle and our strength. But they've been giving it to us. Well, they're supposed to have been giving it to us since we was young. And then the minute we start looking like men, sounding like men, 13, 14, what age you started maturing? You started looking like a young man, and then the world start dispersing you right then and there. Meanwhile, the girl, she gets it from the tomb to the womb. And if she don't get it, we scum for not giving it to her. So the point that I'm making is, this shit is a double standard and it's one-sided. And this is why shit don't last. Because everything, me receiving softness from a woman at this point should not be a job. Why is what I do for you a given, but what you do for me, I got to unlock it. Like we playing fucking Madden or 2K or fucking, what's the game, the shooting game? The shit, I haven't played Call of Duty. You got to unlock the fucking, her softness and her femininity, you got to unlock it like it's the Gatling gun on Call of Duty. The fuck? But me working and lifting and bending and paying, that's, I'm supposed to just give you that. So it all... But that's the end result of what we're talking about. But, nigga, I need to go back to therapy again. It's been a couple of weeks since I've been in therapy. But, no, that's like that's a real thing. So, moving on to the next, we got time. Look at that. When you start on time, you get time. Engineer showed up, you know what I'm saying? Staff showed up. He was like, yo, I'm here. He was here at 10. Wait, Buzz. I'm fucking with you, bro. All right, so moving on to the next topic. Statement, because this is state relate debate. So the next statement is, you show a little love and these weirdoettes think you a sucker. Shaking my head. What do you think that means, Johnny Doe? What do you think that means? You show a little love, you know what I'm saying? You show a little love and motherfuckers try to pull a fast one on you. You know what I'm saying? Then you turn up. Now everybody like, oh, what the fuck is going on? What's your take on this, bro? How many times have you showed love and you felt took advantage of for showing love?
A lot of times. To this day.
That's what that sound like to me.
To this day. But you know what I mean? It's just, that's just you. You know what I'm saying? And to that, it's like people think like you a sucker and they gonna finesse you. You can think that all you want. But when a person that's honest and show true love, when that person stop, it's over. Then you gonna realize like, oh shit. Mm-hmm. And yeah, they gonna think you crazy when you say, oh, they gonna try to manipulate the situation. Like, oh no, it's not that. It's exactly what it is.
Right.
Because you, all you doing is take it. And you know what I'm saying? It's like a bank. Like you got insufficient funds.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Like I'm putting in, I'm depositing. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm not getting the deposit back. So when I go to withdraw, it's insufficient.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So mm-hmm. I can't get the same back.
You killed that. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That I'm
giving. So but I'm a sucker for that?
Right.
Come on, man. No, you the sucker because that's your loss. You know what I'm saying? And that's why I say the best thing you can give a person is your time.
Let me tell you. Because my instinct was saying just now, I was literally thinking time tells everything.
Exactly.
And when you said the best thing you could give a person is your time.
That's it.
That's wild. Talk your shit, bro. Because I got something to say about time.
I can't get that back. I'm giving you something that's real precious that I can't. Hey, Justin, what's going on, bro? I see you.
Yo, what's good, Justin?
I can't get that back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I can't make that back. Money doesn't mean nothing. I can make that back. Clothes, I can get that back.
Yeah.
But my time, I can't get back.
Right.
So when you waste that, and you try to say, oh, you a sucker for me giving you time, or I'm showing you love, out my day, even a text. If I text you, and I have to wait, yeah, that's a problem. That's a problem. So you think I'm really a sucker? Okay. Right. Now we got a problem.
No, let me tell you something, yo. When you begin to learn your value, you learn how important what you give out is become to you. Like the what you give out, you learn how important it is. Like your time, your energy, mm-hmm. your laughter, If I give you my energy, if I give you my time, if I give you a laughter, I'm cutthroat. If I don't fuck with you, you gonna know.
Exactly.
That's where I'm at. I give a perfect stranger a chance before I give a motherfucker I'm supposed to came up with a chance. Because that's what society has dealt me. They say, oh, no new friends. Yo, sometimes the friends you got.
Yeah, they don't need to be around.
Nigga, they
you
be
either.
Nigga, they be trash. You be get, like, you know what I'm saying? So he said, time also reveals a person's true character, that good, the good and the bad. Facts.
Yeah.
No. You gonna get everything. Listen, time is the only thing that sits still and moves at the same time. Mm-hmm. As fast as it goes, is as slow as it go. But it tells you everything. When that time to look back, like, yo, I've been doing this for this many long. I've been working here. I've been entertaining this. I've been rapping. I've been singing. I've been on radio. I've been cool with this person. I've been fucking this person. Like, time. When you put time in on that shit, it's going to reveal a waste or a purpose. I'm going to keep going or or this shit is done up.
But you always gonna learn though. Either way you feel, you gonna learn. It's gonna be a lesson in it.
Mm-hmm. Cuz said, I agree 100. When you do them how they do you, then you're the bad guy, exactly. Nigga. No, the shit that bugged me out is, and then I'm one of them people where you don't want me to match your energy if it's bad. You don't, cuz.
Exactly.
Cuz I'm not one to give bad energy. I'm cool. If I got it, you got it. But I really got to have it so you can have it.
And that's why I hate being, and that's why I dislike being humble.
Bro, I feel like every time you say that, you be taking shots at me.
No.
I got a quote that sound like something you would have said. I almost posted it, but I was like, it's just me and him. I'm not doing that. We'll do that in 2 weeks when we do the segment again. Fuck you. You ain't shit.
No, I'm just saying. Hey, yo, I hate it. I hate it. Like, I really do, because just like you said, be like, people think you were sucking. When I was just, I'm not saying I like being a savage either, but it's like me being a savage, I have more peace being a savage than I have been being humble. And that's crazy how I feel like
that's
that.
That's wild. But that's reality.
Being a savage, because people thought about it, like, damn, how dog gonna react to this.
No, when you think about it, that's really what it is. No, when you think about it, because when you off your shit, everybody's like, please calm down.
Yeah.
It's peace over here. But when you at peace, everybody poking at you, fucking with you.
Yeah, like, you know, yo, why you fucking with the bear? Like,
let the bear
sleep. Or the bull. You fucking with the bull.
Like, you fucking with the bear during hibernation. It's hibernation season. And that's what we doing? You gonna fuck with the bed right now.
So now when springtime come and we doing spring cleaning.
Hey, I'm outside.
And
ain't nobody outside when I'm out there.
Ain't nobody safe.
They in the house.
They in the house. Like, yo, this dude got this nigga started. Cause you know I'm a troll. Before I do something, I'ma troll the shit out you.
Just to see
the reaction. So I'm gonna make you jump. Like,
make
all right.
You uncomfortable.
Yeah, you're gonna be real uncomfortable every time I'm seeing you. Like, yo, you wanna play? Okay. I'm going to make sure you uncomfortable. When I'm in the room, I'm going to make sure you uncomfortable. Every time.
This nigga's a jerk.
I'm going to be like, yo, what's up, dickhead? All types of shit. You going.
Cuzzo said, it's the devil. They want you to turn up and block your blessings. No, it's a gift and a curse. But again, you know, it'd be funny, right? Because it's funny, like, what we talking about right now. I literally be like, you don't want me to go there. Like, my feet is too big to stoop there. It's not gonna be good. I be trying to be like, okay, keep talking. Go ahead. Do stuff. Say stuff. Your feelings gonna be hurt. You're too sensitive for what you're doing.
Exactly.
You should relax.
I've been doing this all my life.
Like, that's
you,
it.
Like, y'all, see, rap, you know, when I go, I don't stop. I don't stop. It's forever.
Oh, you sound like Cardi.
Yeah, it's forever. I'm like Cardi. Yo, that is for eternity. I'm a Taurus.
Word.
I'm a Taurus. We going, yo, you, it's forever. Even when I die, when I see you, it's still forever in the afterlife. We going to have to fight. You either going to have to shoot my fade eventually. I was being humble. I was cool. I was minding my business.
Yeah.
But here you come disturbing my peace. Oh, you going to pay.
Right.
And I'm going to have fun.
Right. He shot the fuck out. He said, Cuzzo said, 50 said, I don't ever want a problem, but they say they want a problem. I say no problem. That's the Bugs Bunny effect. I'm a Bugs Bunny kid, right?
Uh-huh.
In Bugs Bunny cartoons, in the old Looney Tunes joints, Bugs Bunny did not bother anybody. He was just trying to get to Albuquerque, and he always just so happened to make a left turn. And then the people he asked, like, yeah, Doc, I must have made a right turn at Albuquerque. Can you show me how to get where I'm going? And they decide to fuck with him. And he said, oh, so now you niggas want to play.
It was an accident.
I did not understand what was going on with Bugs until I got older, and now I became Bugs. # rap is Bugs Bunny. That's what it is. So somebody put that in the # for me as we move on to the next. Should I give it? You know what? We're going to do one more statement Because at 3:40, we want to play a song and then jump right into Hot Topics.
All right.
All right. So one more statement. It says, the same women, oh, this is crazy. The same women that will demonize you as a man for your masculine energy will call you a gay slur for expressing yourself when the floor finally belongs to you. I think we kind of talked about this a little bit over the last couple of statements without really addressing it.
Yeah,
we kind of talked about it, like healing what you don't reveal, and now you're being demonized when you have feelings and you want to share them. You know what I'm saying? Yo, it's a dirty game. Like these women are killers, yo. But you forget the smallest stuff, like with now, a man, though.
But now it is, like
today they killers, bro. They killers. But
you know what?
And you be looking at them, they be like, "Oh my gosh, you look so good. Your skin's so soft. Why are you so evil?"
Why you ask me that question?
And don't get me wrong, some. I'm not saying all. You got to get context right. They will attack you.
Yeah.
Now, all of y'all know. Listen, it's a few of y'all. It's a few of y'all in the universe. A little spaceship crash, and a few of y'all escape.
That's the hub bug.
And now it's millions of real niggas out here trying to find y'all.
That's the hub bugs that get bad. Like, how you sassy? You know about skincare? Ain't no man should know about skincare. Like, damn, I ain't supposed to wash? When I'm a caveman? But you dirty. Like, what type of niggas you like?
Right.
You like niggas that dirty fingernails, smelling like black, black and miles. Like, I can't smell good.
Justin said, when they are broken, they need to see everyone else in pieces as well. Okay. Question is, who is they? Are we
women?
Oh, you're talking about women.
Yeah.
And they are broken? Nah, it's not. Hold on. It's men that act like that too. It's men that act like that too. So don't let's not make that concept a gender thing. I seen grown men act like that too. Cousin said the nails though, big time.
Right. That's why he showed mine's showing me the kid. But you know what? It's somehow like how times have changed. It's our fault too a little bit.
Okay,
it's our fault a little bit too because it ain't a lot of real niggas left.
No, it ain't even a little bit. It's men gotta like.
They trying to compete with the ladies.
No, it's true, but at the same time. Men gotta learn to express themselves, yo, and be okay. Like you gotta be okay. Like how it's your homeboy would rather kill a whole neighborhood than to go get some help, than to go sit down and cry a little bit and say, "Yo, this shit hurt," or sit with his homeboy, and his homeboy sit with him, and they be like, "Yo, I've been fucked up. Like, where are you two? How we figure this shit out? How do we figure this shit out?" And then here's the kicker. Once two niggas really figure that part out, then society gonna say, "Oh, it's a bromance. Oh, they gay." Because they, nigga, y'all, it's we all we got. So when I see my niggas go through something, I'm like, "Yo, bro, pull up, bro. Hennessy in the fridge. What's up? What we talking about?" You know what I'm saying? I don't need to wait for society to judge you. I'm gonna be like, "Nah, I know what's going on. Come talk to me. I don't judge." I laugh when it be the niggas that be like insecure, but they gotta be tough to overcompensate.
Mm-hmm.
Like, nah, bro, you just trying to get yourself killed. Go talk to somebody. Matter of fact, pour some Hennessy, bro. What we doing? Like, let's talk about this.
They don't
want
to do that.
Yeah.
They want to be. You know, what they like. We well back in the first time. They got a lot of anger that they can't.
Yeah.
There's no outlet.
Yeah.
They feel like there's no outlet.
Yeah, but
when you go to talk to somebody, why you gotta talk to a therapist for? What's going on? Oh, life ain't that bad. You all right? You tough B, like right. Shit like that. Right. You looking like it's deeper than that.
Yeah, like motherfucker, it's deeper than that. You have no idea what I may or may not do.
I'm going through. Like, I'm tired.
Yeah, you have no idea what I feel like right now. You have no idea what I feel like.
I got to get up every day, do the same thing every day. Yeah. And then, on top of me doing the same shit every day, I got to deal with your emotions and whatever bullshit you got going on. So that's not only thing that's on my shoulders, what I got to go through, plus whatever you got to go through, because now you looking for reassurance from me.
Yeah.
Well, damn, I need some reassurance, too.
No, that's true. I say sometimes, like with marriages and relationships, you don't want your woman to be a job that you don't get paid for. You know what I mean? And I'm a nigga. I work hard. How many hours I said I worked this week?
67.
I'm going to get up and get to it. So, motherfucker, if I'm going to get to you, you got to pay me something. And we're talking figuratively. You got to give me something for dealing with you. And 9 times out of 10, the shit you giving me ain't enough. So, bitch, what the fuck is we doing? You know what I'm saying? But, you know, that's...
They don't want to talk about that, though. Yeah. That's another,
but, yeah, so listen, you know, stop demonizing these men when they get the urge to express themselves. Because you don't know what men go through, ladies. You know what I'm saying? It's no man program. We here. All right. Yep. It's
40.
So yeah, so what I'm about to do is, so we're gonna play like a minute and a half for the next song that I'm about to play. Oh shit, I got myself queued up. Real Ass Promise. Yeah, I don't know if y'all know this. I do music too. I might be one of the greatest rappers to ever do this. I ain't gonna lie. I'm like that. The fuck is you talking to me about? What up, nigga?
All right.
I'm a goat, motherfucker.
But he not better than me, though.
Fuck is you? Here you go. Look, here you go. Yeah, look like, he
he's
said
not
what?
Better than me, though.
Word.
I'm nice. I get busy.
All right.
That's why I do this shit.
Talk your shit, son.
I ain't scared of this nigga. This nigga intimidate everybody else. He'll intimidate me. You got me fucked up. I'm nice. I'm nice.
Yeah, with that being said,
fuck you talking about?
We gonna get into some Mr. Yours Truly, Mr. Real Ass Promise. This joint is called Glory off Alumni 3. Yes, motherfucker, my album is available on all music platforms. Shit. But I get the most out of your support if you go to bandcamp.com/realasspromise. The album is only $8.
Get all
but you
them.
Can name your price. You can buy it for more than $8 if you choose. But the album is available now. It's called
go
Alumni 3 by Yours Truly, Mr. Real Ass Promise. And when we come back, we're coming back with the hot topics before we end the show. Your last segment is on the way, and we'll be right back.
All right, all right.
Yeah, listen. 8SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.
I am a movie, but not for the camera. Sorry if ignorance, now I'm my grandma. A little bit of prayer, patience, and prosperity. 3 of many that I got from my grandma. I made a choice that was not to do damage. My choices was there to lock up in the slammer. Just telling my story with no propaganda. Had oodles and noodles, but no Tropicana. The realest approach is to go ahead and run. Since you a bird, I throw bread and crumbs. Never in second, I come in at one. Weighing so heavy, something like a ton. Even if I die up under the sun. My legend living to 801. The essence of my mama presence was a weapon, so I'm guessing I'm a son of a gun. Fatherly quotes, but all of them sons. They talking them notes, but they squat in the slums. They don't got no money, they don't got no guns. They don't got no bands, they don't got no drums. They stomachs and ropes knotted cause of runs. Cause all of them broken out of all they funds. Plus all of them joking, they phony for fun. They call for the smoke, but they don't got the lungs. But you didn't think I would catch them. Why the realness be taking you that long? Cause if you ain't living it in real life, why the hell you put it in a rap song? Know some niggas really going through it. Can't show you they pain, so they keep a mask on. Pray to see 21 may not last long. They ain't lesbian, but keep a strap on. But the pressure was bubbling. Once I was struggling, I tried to drown it in Hennessy. Forgot that the suckers in last place always gunning for the niggas that's in the lead. So I leave them with shit to remember me. Made less friends, more enemies. Cause whenever your star brighten, you gon' notice they jaw tighten like Tennessee. So I tell them it's life and it's not really fair. Can't let you breathe, never nod in my ear. How you gon' deal with me? Gotta prepare. I'm rolling for broke and I got me a spare. For me nowadays, I cannot really care. Deserve to be stingy, cannot really share. Cause love for these niggas remind me of my father's presence and my life is not really
there. I know that I can't help them all. I truly had to duck a few, sharing bread when I barely had a buck or two. Looking at shit, my mama had the muscles through family dysfunction. Nothing like a Huxtable. Swallowed the biggest pill, it wasn't crushable. Now that I've elevated, I'm untouchable. Really, I'm done with downplaying all of my greatness and making all these niggas comfortable. Real men of honor, I don't play king. Real wisdom out of my tooth, I don't just say things. Just pushing my sons after they dream. Should be looking scary for a youngin', I pretty make it to 18. Mama once told me there'd be days like this, but she never said we'd be ducking strays like this. They gon' put us in the dirt or the cup bands. Way too difficult for me to sweep it under the rug. Got too used to the dustpan. I remember when I made a decision to fucking rap, rather than hug a block that'd never hug me back. Not only that, I can't be prison brown. Three strikes, you out, nigga. That judge got bill is a bitch's mound. Fast cars, jewels, and clothes, I can't really mention. How in the hell am I 50 pitching when I'm penny pitching? I never buy into the dreams they be selling me, cause when death creeps into my mind, it's a heavily. Sadness is a common song with a common melody. Small change before I got rocky, it was pebbly. In this life, got all of my stripes, he a referee. For my height, you gon' need a flight, I'm a destiny. So being the best of me is my only weaponry. Hating ain't no stressing me, cause you catch an F and E. Get it pushing until I'm awake, and it's heavily. Only hoping I can catch a break, not a felony. Not a felony.
Glory be it to he that is out.
I've been doing nothing but drinking and thinking, yeah. Oh, since you've been away.
DJ Payne 1.
Your anger came home to an empty bedroom and hangers. Ugly family picture, I'm ashamed to be the painter. Relapsed again, pretty women is my hang up. Struck myself out, I know I pitched it, I would change up. We going in different directions, this ain't the same bus. I ain't the same me, shit, we ain't the same us. Broke your heart with different women, using the same lust. I said, stop crying. She said, how? You won't stop lying. She pushed to make this work, and the day she stopped trying. Go figure, cause now I'm so sicker. Couldn't picture my baby getting crazy on all fours with no nigga. If you a reason, I can't pick it out. I can't take it, but we know that I could dish it out. But I know now that we done, and karma, it revolve around the sun. I'm so dumb, I made us cool when we was one. Another sleepless night. Now we talking child support and visitation rights. A nigga chose to play, now ain't gotta pay. She said cash out, come to get the kids with her ass out. That ain't fair. Heart hurt, but my mouth say I don't care. Homie said, who you think you fooling? Son, until you learn the value of woman, you keep losing. Acting undefeated. I sent the text, I hope you read it. Laid up with the new guy, so you delete it. I slept on your bounce back game. Strategic. You know the measure, get trash, somebody treasure. I said you wouldn't leave, they said never say never. Reminiscing on your letters, oh, you left your leather. Thick as fuck, new truck, you living better. I know now that we done, karma move around the sun. So dumb, I made us two when we was one.
Conversation and fun. We are the voice of the people.
Yep. We are back. Got about 10 minutes left. We are at the final segment of the show. This segment, you know, it's called The Pot. And what are we cooking in the pot? Hot topics.
Put me in Q next week.
You know what I'm saying? Thank you. Thank you, Cuzzo. I appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I'll be trying to, you know, put dough in the queue next week. Yeah, you know, I
got some music, you know.
Yeah, we're going to work that out.
Got I got some music. That's why I'm the.
Yeah, that was like, Act yo, Turner. That was that fighter too. You know, Act he be, you know, Act be rapping, yo.
You trying to hear that? I know. I'm like, you know.
What the fuck is that? You ain't saying nothing.
I'm like an unknown legend.
Okay,
you feel
talk
me?
About it.
I'm like an unknown legend, man. I'm nice out here in these streets, nigga.
Appreciate the love. Fuck. We love you too, cuzzo. You know what I'm saying? So we at the last segment. You know what I'm saying? So what's in the pot? Hot topics
what's
as always.
What's in the pot?
Yeah, we always cooking. You know what I'm saying?
We gotta get like a little jingle for the pot. You know?
Oh no,
I mean?
No, yeah. Oh yeah, nah, facts. I'm we working on it. It'll be here.
What we got, bro?
Yeah, so let's talk Benzino and Eminem.
Why, yo?
No, I have to.
Why?
I have to talk about this.
That nigga,
No. Listen, no. It's this is grown man shit. So Benzino pulled up to Eminem's restaurant titled Mom's Spaghetti in Detroit to shoot his video for his diss song, Rap Elvis. So here's the thing, right? Listen, here's the thing. As a super dope MC like myself, right?
Yes, sir.
Listening to somebody like Benzino, I have nothing against Benzino.
Benzino.
Nothing. And I know for him, it's a lot more passion, it's more deeper for him for whatever reason.
Because he was the Source magazine creator.
Right, and Eminem killed the Source.
Exactly.
Like completely, and with 50, with the help of 50.
So he's his arch enemy.
I get it. You mean he's like, man, fuck the Source. Double XL is the shit.
Yeah, fuck your five mics.
Right, fuck your five mics. We don't care. I get it. I mean, I'm a Source guy, but I like Double XL too. But the point is, this nigga, you showed up to my business establishment, and here's the funny part: motherfuckers kept working. They kept working. And he got the camera on, and he doing this, and they still working. Like, you went. No, my question is, how did he even, like, how? Eminem is God in Detroit. How did he even, like, how does that work?
I don't know, bro. I you know what?
And then on top of that, like, I feel like you reaching. What kind of clout are you trying to reach at this point?
I think that was like a sucker move. Like, you went to his mom's restaurant.
No, but Benzino be, here's the thing. We know your name, but we don't know you for having good raps. We know your name for Eminem cooking you. We know your name for your daughter cooking you. And a couple of other questionable things that you've done throughout the time of us knowing you. But you're not known for music.
Yeah.
So at this point.
Can you name a Made Men track?
The one with the locks on it. That was my shit. Off Belly soundtrack, Tommy's theme. Oh my god.
That's it.
Right. For the locks. Only for the locks part. Cause once the rest of them niggas start rapping, it doesn't matter at that point.
Yeah, like I asked last week, like, who in the car said, yo, put that Benzino on?
But you knew who Maidman was.
Yeah, I knew that was I'm an artist. I'm supposed to know who
made it. Yo, I mean, it may sound like we're slandering. I'm just going with the facts. Listen, I don't know Benzino from the can of paint. I'm not copping, please. Like, nigga, nobody knows you for your music, bro.
Nah, man.
That's just reality.
He a sucker because, like, yo, I'm going to say this. Like, he was on Drink Champs crying. I want to beef with this man. I do cocaine.
Crying about what?
He didn't want to beef with him. Then.
Wait, he was crying for real? I didn't see the interview. See, I don't be checking for Benzino at all. All I know is Carla Rae is his daughter, and Eminem cooked him more than one. About to catch another flight. Hey, and the Bible, we don't want a bite. Hey, I just want to have a good. We love Carla Rae.
He obsessed with him, and that's crazy. Like, you like 50, bro. Sit your punk ass down, go lift weights, and live life. Like.
If I'm him at this point and my daughter is hot, I would be more concerned with that relationship, and even because I know she had her own beef with him too. I'll be more concerned. Like, even if you don't talk to me no more, I still got to make sure every city you go, security is in place, so at least you living. So when shit don't happen to you, I could say, motherfucker, that was me.
Yeah. But you worried
even
about
if you
going
don't talk to me no more. Because I know we live in a day and age. These kids is different. He should be more focused on that, his relationship with his daughter, than like, you don't have time to be. You don't have time to, for this Eminem shit.
But you have mom spaghetti, stealing signs and throwing food on the ground that you pay for. So pretty much you gave that nigga some bread. Whatever right. you pay for, right. you can do whatever you want. I don't care. You go to my establishment, you buy the food, you can throw it, you can do whatever the fuck you want to do. I got the money already. I'm good.
Right.
Cha-ching.
Right. All right, so moving along, you know. So real quick, let me sum that up. Benzino, I think you too old to be doing that, and your music is not relevant enough to be going at Eminem. Period.
Yeah, you.
So
trash,
that's that.
Bro.
Not it's not because I'm knocking you or I hate you or anything. I ain't got no issues with you, but bro, that's M and you're you. Moving on. All right. So let's talk Tiki Barber and Saquon Barkley. So this is the last topic. So you know, the New York Giants did not give Saquon Barkley his money.
Where June at?
You know what I'm saying? Oh shit! Yeah, June, where you at, nigga? Now's the time for you to talk. So they didn't give him his money. So he went to the rivals and they paid him good. And Saquon Barkley said, like, I love the organization. I wanted to stay here. But I got to eat. Y'all got to pay me. They didn't pay. The rival paid. It's a business. I get it. Listen, it's a business. If I've been playing football for more than 5 years and a team is into – I don't think he – has he done 5 years? And a team is interested in me and they still think I'm a high commodity, okay, then pay me something. Because I'm not about to be working for the same – I'm not about to be working on a rookie contract, and I'm not a rookie no more, and the rookie contract is over. Y'all got bands, nigga. Real bands. Real yeah. bands.
I think
so. They took care of Saquon. So Tiki Barber put up a post saying, like, you're dead to us, Saquon. Good luck. You're dead to me. And then Saquon was like, Tiki Barber, you've been a hater since I got to New York. And all the dead to me talk, don't smile in my face when I see you. What that means is, in his world, Tiki Barber on some fake shit. So
yeah, he can't get mad at him.
Tiki Barber, I wanted to say this to Tiki Barber.
Yeah.
Just so you know, Rondé Barber got the ring, not you. Nobody know, they know, I mean, I know y'all twins because I did homework on y'all because Rondé Barber got the ring against my Raiders. Maybe that's why I'm hating a little bit. But Tiki, I mean, you were more popular.
For fumbling. Yeah.
And you were, and niggas knew who you was, but my nigga, you didn't get the ring. Rondé got it. Shut the fuck up. Get fuck out of here.
But this is what they forgot, though. This is what they forgot.
Okay.
The disrespect came in when they paid that unreliable-ass quarterback.
Oh, Eli?
No, Daniel Jones.
Oh, Daniel Jones. Oh, you talking about now. I'm thinking I'm thinking what Tiki was playing.
When they could have paid him.
Yeah.
Now, what they got? Daniel Jones get replaced.
Right. I was about to say, Eli beat the GOAT twice. He's not unreliable. That's
no,
what
I'm talking
I was
about
thinking
Daniel
immediately.
Jones.
About,
because they gave him that extension for all that money.
What they call him now? Danny what?
Danny Dimes.
Danny Dimes.
And he just been dropping pennies. He a fucking sack dummy.
Yo, ladies and gentlemen, it is 3:59.
Him and Zach Wilson, the same nigga.
Yo, y'all stupid. Oh, my
hey, yo,
God.
You know what?
It's time. Our engineer is saying it's time to wrap it up. It is 4 o'clock. Oh, only because we talking about the Giants. Hold on real quick. We fucked y'all up when we got Antonio Pierce that week.
We
y'all scored one touchdown. We kicked up on y'all. That happened. No? You want to talk about it after the show? Got you.
Can I say something to the Denver Broncos before we go?
Real quick. Fuck them, too.
Hey, Denver, I'm going to save y'all some money, right? Listen, just get Zach Wilson, and y'all can keep up. Give him number 3. And y'all ain't got to pay no money for no more uniforms because it's just like a swap.
It's a swap.
It's a Wilson, so you ain't got to pay no money to the
no
NFL.
You ain't got
to
do nothing. He can put the same number on. It's
yeah,
a wrap.
It's a wrap. And he ain't going to get no playing time.
Fuck 10. Keep him at 3. He'll be good.
Yo, right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the No Man program right here every Sunday from 2 to 4. Ladies, we take all the smoke, especially if you're cooking. Everything is on the table. If you want to be a guest on the show, promote your business, promote your music, you can send your music in MP3 form to nomanprogram@gmail.com. You can follow us at no_man_program.
And we had to use the flag today. Live. That's a good day.
Yeah, fact. So we'll be back next week, same time.
Same
and thank
channel.
Y'all. Thank everybody for tuning in. Thank y'all. You know, thanks for the love. Cuzzo, you have a good week as well. And we'll be back next week. You heard?
All right.
Yeah, listen. 8SquadRebelRadio.com.
Yeah.
Good music, conversation, and fun. We are the voice of the people.